Students, welcome back. Let's continue with the VSD, that is a visible surface detection. So in the previous video I explained one of the method, that is a back face detection, that is the object space method. Let me take one more example in the visible space visible surface detection, that is a Z buffer method. So this Z buffer method is an image space approach. It's an image space approach. So if it is an image space approach, means it is implemented in the what system? So whether if it is an object space method, it is implemented in the physical coordinate system. If it is an image space approach, it is implemented in the screen coordination system. Implemented in screen coordination system. Okay, so the basic, what is this basic idea of the Z buffer? The back face detection means whatever the face means the from the viewing point, the back side of this non-transparent object, that face has to be detected and that has to be removed. So that can be do by inside outside test, by using inside outside test. So what is a Z buffer method? So I said this Z buffer method is an image space approach. What is the basic idea of this Z buffer method? The basic idea is to test, the basic idea is to test Z depth, that is a Z depth of each surface, to determine the closest visible surface, determine the closest visible surface. So one thing I had to be tell that in the back face detection, if two objects are overlapping, so let me take this, two objects are overlapping, okay, let me take like this. So here whatever the object that is overlapping, that backside you are not able to see, only the front view, means only this part you are able to see, and this part is cutting off, okay, the backside object. So that is a drawback of this back face detection. In the Z buffer, to overcome that drawback, the basic idea here is to test the Z depth of each surface. So whatever the surfaces that you are taking, here I am taking two surfaces. So one is my this hand, upper hand, and here left hand, and this is a right hand. So by taking these two surfaces, I am calculating the Z depth for each surface to determine the closest visible surface. I am just determining the closest visible surfaces. Okay. Let me explain you this thing. How I am going to detect the closest visible surfaces. Let me draw the picture first. So in this screen coordination system, this is image screen. Let me take the picture. This is one surface I am taking. Okay. And here I am taking one more surface. Okay. And let me take another surface. Okay. So this is the three surfaces I am taking. So here I am seeing from this side, center of point. So I am seeing from this side. So just this point I am taking the center of point. So now this image can be observed like this. First, let me take all three surfaces. So, these are all three surfaces. Okay. So, here in this method, each surface, so whatever the surface is, each surface processed separately. Here, each surface is processed separately, one pixel position at a time. Across the surface. So one pixel position at a time across the surface. So it compares the surface depth at each pixel positions at the projection plane. And it is also applicable, it is applied very efficiently on surfaces of the polygon. So what that Z buffer is applied efficiently on the surfaces of polygon. Here the surfaces can be processed in any order. You can take any order. First you can take this surface, later this, and first this, like this. You can take the surfaces in any order. So to override the closer polygons from the far ones, two buffer names are taken. So let me write that point. To override the closer polygon from the far ones, two buffers named. Two buffers are taken, so they are named, those are named as, one is the frame buffer and another is the depth buffers are used. Depth buffer are used. So what is this frame buffer? So frame buffer means it is used to store the intensity value, value of color value at each position xy. It is used to store the intensity value of color. Intensity value of color at each position xy. And where is the depth buffer? The depth buffer is used to store the depth values for xy position. Depth values for x comma y positions. So as surfaces or depth are in the range between 0 less than or equal to, depth is less than or equal to 1. So this is the range of the depth. So we use to override the closer polygons from the far ones, we use two buffers which are named as a frame buffer and the depth buffer. And the Z coordinates are usually normalized to range from 0 to 1. Okay. So let me explain you the algorithm for using this Z buffer algorithm. Algorithm for Z buffer. Let me write the step 1. Set the buffer values. First step is set the buffer values. So that is the depth buffer. I said two buffers are there. So one is the depth buffer of x comma y is 0, and take the frame buffer. So for frame buffer xy, I'm taking it as a background color. I'm setting the value of the frame buffer as background color. Step 2. Process each polygon one at a time. Process each polygon. So how many polygons you are based on you are taken. So for each polygon you have to process one at a time. For each projected xy, for each projected x comma y pixel, position of a polygon, then calculate the depth Z for each polygon. Calculate depth Z. Suppose if depth Z is greater than depth buffer, if Z is greater than the depth buffer x comma y, then you have to compute surface color. Compute surface color. So after computing the surface color, you have to set depth buffer x comma y is equal to Z. Okay, then the frame buffer x comma y is equal to the background color. Which, what is the background color? The background color here is the surface color xy. Whatever the surface you are taking, that surface color has to be assigned x comma y. So this is the algorithm for the Z buffer method, that is the depth buffer. Let me write the advantages of using this depth buffer. The advantages are, it is easy to implement. It reduces speed problem if implemented in hardware. And it processes one object at a time. So these are the advantages of using this Z buffer. Then what about the disadvantages? The disadvantages here is it requires large memory, because each object has to be, each surface has to be verified. It requires large memory and it is time consuming process. Thank you.